The following video is a recording of a book review given in Oakland, California by Saphir Robb.
What would be, out of all of your two, what would be one that you would highlight, and what would be the practical application of that in our everyday life? Just one. I know it's a lot, but whatever one comes up.
Okay, well, I'm going to tell you one. I'm going to veer off a little bit because I seem like I have a little bit more time. So I'm going to explain it to you from a different perspective. Okay. And that is, the highlight of the Hajj is the Arafat. Right. When Allah says, I'm going to make a Khalifa in the earth, He had dispatched the angel Gabriel and told him to bring me the essence of the earth so that I could fashion man into shape. An angel Gabriel came to the earth, and the earth says, I seek refuge with Allah from you disfiguring me. And so the angel Gabriel answered the dua of the earth rather than obey the commandment of Allah. So then he went back to Allah and says, I would have brought you the essence that you commanded me, but your servant, who I know is a righteous servant, sought refuge in your name. So I answered his prayer. So then he sent the angel Michael, and he did the same thing. And he sent another angel, and another angel, and another angel. He kept sending angels, till finally he sent Israfil. And the earth told Israfil, I seek refuge with Allah from you disfiguring me. And Israfil said, I seek refuge with Allah from what he would do to me if I don't obey his command. He began to take the essence. And so they said he took some of each type of essence and took it back to Allah so he could fashion man into shape. And that's what he did. Allah says, because you have obeyed my command, I'm going to give you a promotion. You will be known as the death angel. So now the death angel has his post, which is to extract the essence. I think that's very important to remember, and I want you to keep in mind that I'm answering your question, what was the most important part about Hajj. I'm getting to it, but I gotta lay the foundation first. Now, when the prophet was on his deathbed, death angel knocked on his door, and he asked the angel Gabriel, who's knocking at my door? He said, it is one of Allah's servants. And he has under his command 100,000 angels. And each one of them have under their command 100,000 angels. Prophecy, tell him to come in. He comes in. He says, I've come to see if you are ready to meet your Lord. The prophet said, do you normally ask? He said, no. And after you, I will never ask again. The angel Gabriel told Prophet Muhammad, your Lord is anxious to meet you. So he said, do what you've come to do. The reason why I pointed that out, because I did the math. 100,000 times 100,000 is 10 billion. There ain't even 10 billion people on the planet. What you need with that many death angels? I concluded, and I'm giving you this as Saphir's opinion, that I do know that angels exist in tribes. So I believe, just like there's a jinn assigned to each one of us, there's the ruh, which is a member of the tribe of the angel Gabriel assigned to each one of us. I think there's a death angel assigned to each one of us. But I don't think he's ending our life. I think he's taking the essence out of our deeds, out of our thoughts, out of our actions, as we perform them every day. I don't think it just comes at the end. I think he's with us all of the time. Why do I bring that point out? It's because we should be mindful that when Adam and Eve meet at Arafat, that's the faith and our desires within us. This piece of earth is where they meet. And I'm going to tell you something else, another ayah. Where Allah, when he put them out of paradise, he said, get thee down from here with enmity between you. And that bothered me. I said, wait a minute. I can see how enmity can be between Satan and Adam and Eve. But he said, all of you. In the words of Allah, is good for all times. And I thought about it. I said, you know what? I am not trying to provoke enmity between a husband and a wife. But I can actually see that if we don't look at two physical beings and look at our desires and our faith, they're not aligned. Our desires is more things of this world. Our desires is money, opposite sex, power, glory, other things. It's not a lot. We have to align our desires with our faith. They need to get married. And I know Iman Shihoy talks a lot about marriage. So I'm pretty sure he's going to tell you all that more about this. But what I'm saying is the real marriage is the one within. It's the human potential of our faith and our desires. Now, why am I saying that? Because I'm going back to Arafat. When they meet one another and recognize one another and cohabitate in this earth, so they can live now, not with enmity between them, but for the pleasure of Allah. And that definitely is extracting the essence. This is the making of man. Man, like I said, wasn't made in paradise. The potential of man was made in paradise. The real man is made in the earth. I'm going to draw another analogy, and since we have the time, I think we can explain this. When we're in the womb of our mothers, the sperm and the ovum, which is the masculine and feminine, meet, and they go through a process called mitosis, and they split, they split, they split. At some point, Allah breathes into it of His spirit, and I am certain that He's the one who directs them. Okay, now I need a squad of y'all to go over here and develop the heart. I need another group of y'all go ahead and develop the brain. Y'all become the ears, you become the eyes, you become the hands, you become the legs, y'all make bones. So we structure our human biology. But we don't need any of that in the womb of the mother. So why did we develop all of that? Because we were preparing ourselves for the next dimension we're going to live in. So we die as that kind of life, as an embryo in the womb of the mother. And we're born in the womb of Mother Earth. In the womb of Mother Earth, the same process begins again. We develop all of the body parts that we're going to need in the next dimension. And this is where the death angel is taking these little essence and making those cells. And that's where I'm going. I'm still talking about Hajj. I'm still talking about Arafat. And I'm telling you that the masculine and the feminine now are producing deeds of righteousness. They're producing deeds for the pleasure of Allah. And that means he was taking themselves out as soon as we make them. That's the making of man. That's the Khalifa fil art. That's the Khalifa in the earth. That's the making of man. He didn't say, I made man in paradise. He said, I'm going to make man in the earth. We're being made. Hajj tells us this is how we are made. At least he tells me that. So if you ask me that question, I'm telling you, that's the most important aspect, Arafat. But I don't see Arafat like other people see it. I see it the way I'm telling it to you. And I hope you can see it too.
We appreciate the way you see it. Thank you.
Thank you.